everything all right?
Oh, bless you. Oh, thank you for asking. I'm Betty. Betty Bugbrook. And no, everything is not all right. It's my dear friend Hazel. She's in trouble.
Hazel?
Yes. Oh, she's a unicorn. Known her for years. She doesn't like to leave the forest, so I visit her once a week to brush out her mane and bring her some treats. Her coat is glorious. Well, the last time I saw her, we were violently attacked by a pack of wolves. Hazel, loyal friend that she is, leapt in front to protect me, and in the process, I fear she may have been injured.
I'm sorry to hear that.
I want to help her, but she seems to have gone into hiding. Out of fear, I'd imagine. I know you Hogwarts students learn a fair bit about caring for beasts. Perhaps you could find my unicorn friend and get her somewhere safe so that she can heal.
I'll keep an eye out for your unicorn friend and take her to safety if I see her.
Oh, you've a good soul. I can always tell. Please, don't risk your own safety, though. I don't know precisely where she is, but I can tell you that her den is north of Hogsmeade. And although I haven't been able to brush her lately, I imagine she still has the brightest, most beautiful coat of her entire herd. Remember, you'll know her by her brilliant coat. And be warned, she's a stubborn girl. She may need some convincing to come with you.
I need to look for a unicorn with a beautifully bright coat. Sounds as if she's in trouble.
You might as well.
Sometimes it seems all roads lead to Hogsmeade.
Revelio.
No need to be difficult. I mean you no harm.
Betting on the dragon fights was the best decision I've made yet.
Crucio!
You've made a mistake!
Revelio! Revelio. Revelio. Madam Bugbrook, I found your unicorn friend, Hazel.
Oh, what a relief! Is she all right? Are you all right? Do you have a safe place for her to stay?
We're both fine, and I have a safe place for her at Hogwarts.
You've a kind heart, you do. I'm relieved and thankful that you'll take care of her. I shall miss my sweet pointy pony, but I know she's safer away from the poachers. Do give her a nice brushing for me, won't you? Take good care of Hazel now. Got my owl. I need to tell him and the keepers that Ranrok knows where the last repository is.
According to the owl I received, Ranrok is moving more quickly than we could have anticipated.
This is grave news indeed. We had hoped for more time to discuss the best path forward.
Let us hear what the student has to say.
Professor, you received my owl. Ranrok has the last of Bradbor's journals. He killed Lodgok to get it. He knows where the last repository is.
Godric's heart.
Lodgok and Ranrok were brothers. Lodgok was bringing the journal to me.
Ranrok is a monster. We need to know where the final repository is.
Surely this changes things. Ranrok has Bradbor's journals and knows where the final repository is.
We obliterated Bradbor. He kept journals? Why would he have documented all of this? He didn't know what we were containing.
Isadora told Bragbor about the magic when she asked him to build a container for her. I've seen her memories.
Isadora left memories for someone to find? You know what she did?
Her memory showed what she did for her father, which I also saw in Professor Rookwood's pensive. And a conversation with Bragbor in which she expressed frustration about the limits being placed on her use of ancient magic.
Based upon the memories they have seen, I believe our young friend is well aware of the grave circumstances in which we find ourselves. The next trial will involve an exceptional level of magical skill and a nuanced ability to interact with beasts. Find a face of stone and tendrils. I should advise you that you must engage with any beast that is part of the trial on your own. Professor Bakar will meet you in his pensive room.
An exceptional level of magical skill? Nuanced ability to interact with beasts? I suppose we should begin our search for a face of stone and tendrils, whatever that may be.
Very well.
Professor Weasley has been keeping an eye on me. Perhaps we should meet there, so she has no reason to raise concerns with Professor Black. I shall see you near the coast. Perhaps then you can tell me a little more about the memories of Isadora that you witnessed.
Stupendous.
dying, and I'm without my friends.
Up to now.
Blockade. Brooke was supposed to fall over the edge.
Revelio.
Confringo! Revelio! Revelio. Seems as if it wants me to follow it. I need to find it before the poachers do. Revelio. Revelio. Confringo! Looks intriguing.
Avada Kedavra!
This place has seen better days. Seems a pleasant enough little place.
What if he's lonely?
How nice to see you, my young friend.
Hello, madam. Is everything all right?
I'm simply beside myself since Rococo ran away. He's my pet Niffler.
I'm sorry to hear that your pet is missing.
Thank you. I appreciate your words. I mean, I've had him for years. He's lovely company. Whilst on our morning constitutional the other day, south of here, he and I stumbled upon Henrietta's hideaway. They say that Henrietta was a paranoid recluse, filled her castle with all manner of traps to keep thieves from pinching her valuables. As we drew near, the morning sun reflected off something in a window, and before I knew it, Rococo was off. Oh, I've been worried sick, but I'm not about to meddle with Merlin knows what's inside that house, or the Ashwinders that are lurking about.
I'll keep an eye out for Rococo.
Oh, that's terribly kind. But stay away from the hideaway. Far too dangerous. If someone does find him in the hideaway, they shall be well rewarded. Henrietta's treasures are theirs for the taking. She certainly won't mind now.
What do you have for sale?
What's brought you here today?
That hideaway does sound intriguing. Perhaps I should investigate, for Rococo's sake.
Can never have enough stock. That's what I say. Thank you for stopping by.
Revelio. Could prove dangerous if I'm not careful.
You're here. I have good news. We do not have any of Ranrock's loyalists to contend with. Of course, the bad news is that it's likely because they no longer need to track the Keepers for information.
Revelio.
Recognize the head sculpted there?
It looks like a graphorn.
And the prints carved into the ground lead me to believe that a graphorn will somehow open the way forward.
That's what Professor Rackham meant when he spoke of my needing an ability to interact with beasts.
It would seem so. I do know that the last of a long dynasty of graphorns lives nearby. They call him the Lord of the Shore. I suspect you'll need to bring him here. What happens next, I can't say.
If that's what must be done, I'll do it.
Excellent. I know this area well enough. When you see the remains of a large sea creature, you're in the right place. Now, Professor Rackham made it clear that you must engage with any beast that is part of this trial on your own. So I shall wish you good luck and wait for your return in the map chamber.
Very well. Lord of the Shore, show yourself.
Thank you.
We're crossing that bridge whether you like it or not.
Perhaps Professor Rockholm was right to have had faith in you. I still have my reservations. Isadora, as you will see, was not who she seemed. I can only hope that you are. My memories should answer any questions you may have about the power you will need to protect.
Thank you, Professor Bakar. I shall see you back in the map chamber.
Hello? Isadora? Isadora?
Son, I'm glad you're here.
Isadora was not at her home.
I know.
Her father. Percival.
What is it?
It is as though he was stripped not only of his pain, but of all emotion.
Everything is much worse than I feared. Meep was right. Isadora hasn't stopped. I've just learned that she has been wielding that magic on students.
We must gather the others.
return to your common room, all right?
Below Hogwarts, where you fought Isadora. Is that the location?
It is. We also realized, hence, we became keepers. Keepers, we built the trials to lead.
Have I not proven myself, Professor? I need to get to that repository before Ranrok does.
You have, and you will. But the repository is protected by powerful ancient magic. To enter, you must craft a special wand from the four artifacts you found above our pensives.
So the repository is safe from Ranrok for now?
If he is, as you suspect, capable of using the power of the other repository, I fear he will be able to breach our defenses.
Then I must go now and craft this wand. Perhaps Mr. Ollivander will help me.
Another Ollivander? I'm not surprised. As I am sure he will tell you, this wand may be used for only one purpose. Return with the wand, and we will open the way forward.
I shall send an owl ahead to Ollivander. Whilst you visit him, I'll reach out to Professor Weasley.
Professor Weasley?
Yes. I may have made an error in judgment by not informing her of Ranrok's intentions earlier. I only hope it's not too late. If Ranrok really is going to try to drill below Hogwarts, we'll need all the help we can get.
All right, Professor. I'll see you soon. poachers. I have it here. It's safe.
Remarkable. Well, what are you waiting for? Dee cannot wait to... Professor Weasley and Deke were right to tell you about the Room of Requirement. Look at all you've done, and how many beasts you've rescued. A phoenix is safe now, because of you.
I couldn't have done it without your help, Deke. Thank you.
Deke is grateful for the kind words, and also grateful to have been of assistance to someone like yourself. Helping you do such good for so many beasts has given Deke a sense of peace Deke hasn't known in years. Deke will always be here for you when you need him.
Thank you.